Hello, this is Dr. R. Rajamanikam. Today I am here to share one of our humble and simple initiative for keeping our environment safe and clean. It is a cloth bag initiative. I am very happy, I am very glad that it reached Pondicherry in a short period of time. In fact, we started this initiative before Tamil Nadu government gave ban on 14 different type of plastics. It was some 1 year before. And why we are interested in cloth bag manufacturing, or you know, introducing best eco-friendly cloth bags to society. Let me introduce myself a little bit widely. I completed my degree, my PhD, on ecology and environmental science. After doing environmental science, I had several opportunities. I would have done EIA, Environmental Impact Assessment, or Environmental Management, you know, for some companies or some corporates. I would have earned really good. But after learning about environment, I was thinking all this global warming, climate change, whatever this urban environmental issues, without getting local people participation or support, it cannot be solved. So after finishing my PhD, or even during my PhD, I started working with various NGOs, social welfare organizations, CBOs, community based organizations, and then with even self-help groups actually. So my main subject was waste management. So I was designing solid waste management for gated communities, schools, small scale cottages, even settlements actually. So I started with Shudham NGO, who was a pioneer in waste management at Pondicherry. They were doing really good, like they started door-to-door collection, and then transportation, recycling, composting. So they introduced great things for Puducherry when it comes to waste management. From Shubham, I was started working with Pondicam. Pondicam is another NGO who have been dealing with different coastal and environmental issues at Pondicherry. After doing with Pondicam, I started with Eco Service at Auroville. It's a international township. So I was given this task, like managing, the garbage, the solid waste. So I was a kind of supervisor, manager, and then we trained so many people, especially the scavengers and sanitation workers, and then the community, very interesting part. So during our very days, I got suddenly kind of very interesting offer at Kodaikanal. So I came to Kodaikanal. I started working with several schools, local community, hotels at Kodaikanal. So one thing was very keen at Kodaikanal. Kodaikanal is a hill station. It is a wildlife sanctuary, and it is an ecologically sensitive area. So Tamil Nadu government, they have banned all this single-use plastic at Kodaikanal. But still, many shops, like exactly 2 years before, many shops, many commercial buildings were intensively using this low density carry bags, also many other single use plastics. So I was thinking, like, how to do effective management of the single use plastics. We have collected them through public participation. After collection, when we sent them to recycling industry, nearby recycling industry, they told they are not interested in recycling this single-use plastic because they are not very valuable. After doing recycling, in fact, it is not recycling, they call it downcycling actually. So after doing this downcycling, whatever material made out of the single-use low-grade, low-density plastics cannot be bought by, you know, rich people, or it is not having good marketing value. So they decided they are not interested in collected single-use plastics, mainly carry bags. So it was a huge task for us actually, because after empowering, educating people through their effective commitment, we collected huge quantity of single-use plastics, carry bags, PET bottles. After sending them to recycling industry, PET bottles are really having good recycling circulations. But when it comes to carry bag, nobody interested in buying it. So we decided it is not having any recycling industry in and around Kodaikanal. So somehow we wanted to avoid them. Somehow we wanted to educate people that you can't use. If you're using, if once it is wasted, it is going to cow stomach, or it is buried in land, or it is struggling in a stream actually. So meanwhile, interestingly, Kodaikanal people started promoting a cloth bag. It is white. It has all the qualities or structures of cloth bag. And once I decided, okay, why not? Let us have this cloth bag and I will also promote it. So after buying this bag, I decided to burn it. While burning it, I decided it is not a cloth bag. Then I started this background researches. It shows this white color polypropylene bag. It is purely plastic. Purely made out of plastic. Then I understood 13 years of my hard work on community outreach. Like I am meeting people, giving presentation, training them on using green products. Once people are happy, once people are changing, what they get at market, it is again another form of plastic. So I decided instead of reaching people through a message, I have to reach people through a product. Reaching people through a message, definitely people are inspired, empowered, they wanted to change. But when they change, they can't get product at market actually. So as a community outreach guy, I don't think so like I can influence or reach these industries because it is really tough. Since they have huge profit, these industries are based on raw material, means available raw material, and how much money they can make it very fast. So I decided, okay, let it not be just message, information, let it be a product. So I started searching different cloth bag industries. I started meeting lot of people. Finally, I decided four different qualities which I should not sacrifice myself when I am doing this cloth bag. First thing, it should not be single use, because being as an environmentalist, I am very keen like products life is much important when compared to any other issue in India. So if people are buying a cloth bag, using it for just one time and throwing it out, it is not environmentally good practice. So I decided this cloth bag should be durable. So at least 6 months they should use, and then at least 60 times they should be washable. So what I decided, when I went to this local cloth bag manufacturer, I empowered myself how to make thick cloth bags. Second thing, they should be affordable. It should not be more than a dosa cost actually. Since we are developing country, I don't want to impose people to buy expensive bags for avoiding plastic. So I decided it should be around 45 or maximum 50. Second thing, the ink. Many cloth bag they are made out of purely cloth, but the ink they use they are really harmful to nature, especially soil microorganisms and soil characters. So I decided I don't want to use ink. If I'm using ink, it should be quantified ink actually. Like whatever ink I'm using for this particular bag, this is quantified actually. Like if you are buying a newspaper, after reading newspaper, if you are throwing that, whatever impact it is giving to soil, the same impact only the bag also gives. So the ink used in this bag, it is quantified. The fourth important thing, people should relate this bag. People should relate this issue. This is not my issue. This is not my initiative. I want this to be people initiative. So wherever I am launching this product, I'll be using local environmental issue. For example, for a Kodaikanal bag, we named the bag as the Princess Bag. The Princess Bag, because Kodaikanal is they call it Princess of Hills actually. If this situation is continuing actually, Princess, the Kodaikanal, she lose her status actually, because everybody dumping carry bags in a hill actually, and it is looking very ugly. It is going to pollute our environment. It is going to impact poor people life. So we decided the princess of Kodaikanal, she herself donating or introducing this bag to local community. So we call it, it is a princess bag. Not only that, we made a logo which represent very rare bird you can see only at Kodaikanal, only at Palani Hills, especially Kodaikanal, Munnar. It is Palani Solaikili actually. It is very rare actually. And then we kept the mountain ecosystem as a symbol, healthy Chola forest, unavoidable eucalyptus plantation, man-made lake, in lake all the commercial activity. So the logo, the design, and then the caption also. So after doing everything, we started circulating this bag at Kodaikanal. So far, it is reaching people very effectively, and people who are buy this bag, I am not saying them they should come and buy it again actually. I always say this bag is a model for a bag, cloth bag actually. So whenever, wherever people buy this, they empower, they are educated on how the cloth bag should be made. What is exactly this cloth bag? When it comes to Puducherry, we wanted to represent one strong issue, especially at Puducherry. Personally, myself, I am conducted several research or documentaries on sensitive ecosystems. Like we are losing our sand dunes, TDF, tropical ray evergreen forest, they are no more, they are like in small patches now. And then healthy mangrove, we have more than 100 acre of mangrove, but nobody can say they are mangrove, because now people are treating it as a waste dump or waste disposal area. And then we have bird sanctuary, we have a lot of water tanks which attracts migratory birds. So what am I going to represent when it comes to Puducherry for the bay bag? Finally, we come across one specific issue. It is about olive ridley sea turtle. You know, how they contribute to marine life, how they contribute to marine ecosystem, how they contribute to coastal ecosystem and fisherman's life. They are really amazing. They are really amazing creatures. They lay hundreds of eggs. When the eggs are hatched, when the eggs are half hatched, this not hatched eggs, they are contributing to marine vegetation as a fertilizers. Once the marine vegetations are there, they are trapping the sand and they are contributing, or they are forming this healthy sand dunes. So once I decided this marine life is strongly contributed by the special animal actually, olive ridley sea turtle, we wanted to have definitely olive ridley sea turtle. Not only olive ridley sea turtle, at Puducherry we have Puducherry's endemic, but when it comes to world endangered species like Puducherry shark and then mangrove species, so we decided to keep marine life as our theme for Puducherry bag. After making a bag, we were very happy. It has started reaching people. You can see your hand, whatever bag you have, it is the bay bag. Exactly 3 months after our launch, we come across this particular news actually through Google. UNDP, they took saving marine life as this year's theme actually. Whatever image, whatever animal they represented in their logo, it is almost whatever we decided. So whatever we represented at bay bag. So finally we are very happy, since we are local people. We started at locally, but now it is recognized, or at least reaching international community. So one request from my side, as an ecologist or as an environmentalist or as a sociologist, I tried a lot. I was trying to communicate with people. I try to empower them through my knowledge by using strong information. But last 1 year, when I started reaching people through my product, it is the real change. It is the real change. It is the real change. So please be as a change. Be proud of you know, being part of this particular interesting moment. So our aim is reaching wider community, wider audience on using eco sustainable lifestyle products. Thank you.